Hello, I'm Jack. Here's my ID and my little index card. Here
Pizza quick. How many of you guys have surfed before? What about grown up by the beach and just never gave it a shot? My name's Jack, and I've been surfing since I was 10. I live across the street from the beach, and it's one of my favorite hobbies. Today, I want to talk about surfboard shapes. I brought my own surfboard, just to, clarify some stuff. Today, we're going to be talking about the shape of your surfboard, the volume, and exactly what that is, and how that affects your surfboard. We're going to be talking about the fins. First, let's break down the shape. There are two main types of shapes. There's longboards and shortboards. Here you get all the plethora in between. This is going to be your longboard used for smaller waves when you want to catch more waves. And the shortboard for bigger waves where you need less board in the wave. The shape plays a lot of pivotal roles. It's matched on your ability, your level of how long you've been surfing, the conditions at hand, and how much money you really want to put into it. Online Surfer Today website recommended that novices use soft top surfboards. It's not pictured in here, but I wore the shirt that I worked for. I worked for a surf, not surf company, but a surf school back in Daytona Beach where I live, and we would teach novices every weekend or on the days that they would come on soft top surfboards because they're basically made out of foam, and foam has a lot of volume. And if you could put that next one, that segues into the next topic. Volume. Volume has a lot to do with your surfboard. It has to do with how much foam is inside of it. Right here, you can see that these are the dimensions, the length, how tall your board is, the width, and the thickness. If surfboards are a little bit more complicated than your common volume equation, the length times width times height or times width, it's more about this. This is a complicated shape. It's not a rectangle. You can see it, right? And so on my surfboard, the volume is right here. It says it. It's calculated by the professionals, and the volume has to do with your influences how easy it is to catch waves. Longboards are very easy to catch waves because they have a lot of volume. Soft top surfboards, they have a lot of volume because they're basically made of foam. On this board, it's a short board, but it still has more volume than the regular short board because it has a fuller outline. Shapers are actually trying to actively put more volume in shorter boards because it gives some people an advantage. One of my favorite pro surfers, actually, Rob Machado, in a 2014 Surfer Magazine interview, one of my top favorite surf magazines, he reported how exactly he was fitting all that volume into his boards, like where. For instance, a lot of my volume is held out in my nose, which is the top section of your board. He discussed the advantages that he felt in certain wave conditions. Now let's talk about something else, the fins. The fins, there's like shortboards and longboards, there's two main types. You're going to have, well, not types, the setups. We're going to have the quad, which is four fins, or the tri, also known as the thruster, which is three fins. Actually, a study by the Australian Journal of Mechanical Engineering found that both of these setups have about the same lift. I'm not really too sure what lift was, because for me, I'm used to drive, which is how much speed you get from the fins. I think lift would have to do with drive, but it doesn't really make too much sense to me how these are exactly the same from the study. Because personally, I feel a vast difference when I'm riding a thruster or tri to a quad. Right now, in my board, I have a thruster because I wanted some more maneuverability. The thruster allows some more maneuverability, in my opinion, and but you sacrifice a little bit of speed. The thruster on the opposite end of the spectrum gives you a little bit more speed, but you're going to lose a little bit of maneuverability. Something that I could compare it to is a skateboard. This one would be more like your trick skateboard that you ride at a skate park. You're tic-tacking around, you can't really pivot. And then the thruster is more like a longboard. You're going down the hill and you can kind of carve. So yeah, that is about the basics of a surfboard. Hopefully I gave you guys enough information about how to approach a surfboard in the future. We talked about the shape and the plethora of different types, the two main types of being longboard and shortboard. And then we talked about the volume and how that affects the wave count and how many waves you can catch. And then we talked about fins and how they affect your ride. Okay, slide. That's the end of my presentation. Hopefully you're going to be able to see this in the future. And next time you make it down to the beach, let me know. And let's go surf. Oh, yes, Q&A. Any questions?
Which board do you prefer, long or short?
You know, it, like I said, with the conditions, it has to vary with the conditions. Like, sometimes the waves might favor one or the other, so it's just kind of... whichever. I like riding them all, so...
How long does it, like, take people to be able to learn how to surf?
It depends on how, like, athletic you are. I mean, usually really athletic people pick it up very quickly. When I was teaching people, some people had a very hard time with that. Usually, like, not really so much kids, but I'd say, like, maybe 25-year-olds and above seem to have a much harder time to learn. But it's still about, you know, popping up and getting and having that balance of time. Not to practicing. Any other questions? Oh yeah, actually I have. I've surfed in Ireland and I've surfed in Puerto Rico. Yeah, that's about it. I want to add Puerto Rico. So, yeah. Well, thank you guys.